The English Teacher YouTube channel, videos for success in English 103 and English 104.
Hey guys, and welcome back to the English Teacher YouTube channel. I'm here with a quick video to hopefully help you understand one of the essential skills to be able to complete research and properly document that research for the This I Believe essay, but also for the essay that you'll do throughout the rest of the course. So one of the things that we're looking at in particular within this first unit for the This I Believe essay is, can you cite an electronic source, meaning a story from the This I Believe website, such as this one here. So what we would do is we would want to make sure that we go in and we would find an essay. So whatever essay that may be, so we might use this one right here. And we've got to be able to pick out some specific information from this web page or this story in order to cite it properly and give credit where credit's due. Well, the MLA, Works Cited Electronic Sources, web publications page, long name, on Purdue OWL, helps us do that properly. So we can read all the stuff at the beginning of this. I think probably the best area to look at is the basic style for citations of electronic sources, because it lays out the primary elements or the primary pieces that you need in order to properly cite something on a Works Cited page for MLA 8. Now, to get to this page, a couple things that you want to do: go to Purdue OWL, and then you can go over here to the left-hand side underneath MLA style. You would click MLA formatting and style guide, and then you would click on right below that, once that opens up, MLA Works Cited electronic sources. So once you understand some of those basic elements for the citation itself, such as author, article in quotations, the title of the website, the publisher information, all of that good information, you can then start to look at some of the examples, or you can use this basic format that's located right down here to where it shows you, you would go step by step with these particular elements. I generally prefer to scroll down to the area where it provides me with examples so that I can just follow those examples straight across. What I like to do is basically take these, I will copy and paste it. So I'll move here and I will go into my Microsoft Word document and I will say, okay, I know I'm citing a web page. I'm going to go ahead and merge the formatting so I don't lose anything. And then I can start changing things accordingly. So if we go back to our This I Believe essay that we're looking at, we know we've got to have the author, which is right here. We've got to have the title of the web page or of the essay. We also have to have the This I Believe .org organization, and then the URL, and then you want to have the access date at the end. So we're going to follow that basically to a T. So I'm going to go right down below here and I'm going to start creating this information for myself. So as I do this, let's see here, we'll move this right here and we will move this right here. Okay, so we want to go back to the Remembering All the Boys essay. I'm going to make that a little bit larger so we can see those things we need. So it looks like it goes last name, then the first name. So we would type that in like so. Then we would type their first name. Notice that I did put the comma in between there because that's what follows in the example. Punctuation is very important here. Then I would use quotations around the title of the essay, which in this case is Remembering All the Boys. Okay. And then I would put a period because that's what it shows in the example. Then I would use the title of the website. So not the web page here, but the website. So we'd scroll up and we'd say, okay, this is the This I Believe. And it's this. We want to italicize that because that's what it shows in the example. So we would have This I Believe. Oop, I misspelled. This I Believe.org. then we would have a comma as it shows in the example above. And then we would do the URL. So we come up here, we'd copy and paste the URL from the address bar. We would paste it in here. Okay, and then you'll notice that up in this URL that we have for the eHow website from the example, it doesn't have the HTTP. So we want to make sure that we get rid of that, and we go with the thisibelieve.org. After the end of that, we're going to put a period as it shows. Then we're going to put the access date, so accessed, and then you follow the format of the day, month, year. So the day that I'm accessing this is 23 June 2020, and then you put a period. Now, a couple things you want to remember is that as you do this, we do need a hanging indent. So in order to do that on my keyboard, I'm going to hit control and tab, and you'll notice that it shifts that second line out. I want to make sure that I double space this as well. So I'm going to make this large at this point. I'm going to come up here to where I have my paragraph settings and my spacing, make it double spaced, and then I get rid of the URL, the hyperlink, not the URL, my apologies. So we'll remove the hyperlink, and we have a perfect example of how to do a works cited entry for a story from the This I Believe website. Okay, so hopefully you found that helpful. If you have any questions, of course, email your instructor, take a look at the other resources available on Purdue OWL and on your Moodle page. Other than that, good luck with the assignment, guys.